UL softball and Georgia State couldn't be further apart when it comes to opposite ends of the spectrum. The Cajuns are the number 10 team in the nation with a 42-4 record and the best start to Sunbelt play in conference history. Meanwhile, the Panthers have only won 7 games all year. Jerry Glasgow and crew hoping to break out the brooms for a spring sweep on Easter Eve. Sarah Hudak was certainly ready to light it up. First inning, her double was going to bring home Raina O'Neill, and it's 1-0 Louisiana. Summer Ellison again was lit in the circle. 4 innings, 7 strikeouts, allowing only 5 hits and 1 earned run. Now bottom third, now 2-0. Hudak is going to spark some more runs. This time at the plate, she singles up the middle to bring in O'Neill again. 3-0 UL. And then later in the inning, 2 on for Courtney Grimion. She smokes a single to left. Hudak slides in for a run to make it 4-0 Cajuns. And then next batter, UL is going to go for the steal, but the errant throw to third is going to allow Alyssa Dalton to blaze her way into home. Cajuns take a 10-2 victory in 5. Louisiana has now won 19 straight, while Ellison in the circle herself has accounted for 17 of those dubs. All 3 wins this weekend were by run rule, which only helps the Cajuns to preserve energy coming down the stretch.
I think it's super important. Last year, we always played over 7 innings, and by the time we went to regionals, we were just hurting. I think we understand that happened, so that was a big part of this year. We wanted to put games away early. Coach Glasgow's always telling us to, when you get them good, put them away.
We went through a stretch where it was 8 or 10 games where we were scoring 3-4 runs, and everything's relative, but you know, we wanted to see our offense get really rolling again and get some momentum going into postseason where, you know, when you get to the NCAA tournament, I like to think we could score 6-7 runs in any game we play.